So opening is a compound operation. So erosion and dilation are primitives. And it's a erosion followed by a dilation. Okay? So that's what a opening is. And it says here you can show that an opening of something of A by B is the union of all the translations that fit entirely within A. That's kind of complicated and wordy. It's much easier to see in a picture. So here's our binary thing A, and this is our structuring element B. And the opening is all the places, all the translations within A that you can fit B. And when you do that, you would get out this thing here. And you'll notice that it has broken the connection between those two triangles, and it's also rounded the edges. So it's not surprising that it's broken them because it's too small and the whole thing doesn't fit there. And the rounding is because of the shape with B. It says here in Yannis's slide, the opening is the area that we can paint when the brush has a footprint of B and we're not allowed to let the brush get outside of the original image A. One of the other cool things is if you take a look at this, if I now have this shape, I were to open with B again, well, it fits everywhere inside of there, so it wouldn't change, right? That is, if I kept going, it would stay the same. And that's referred to as idempotent or idempotent. I don't know how you pronounce it. I know how to spell it. It's an operation that when you repeat it, it makes no change. So if you erode and then dilate, you get something. Well, if you then erode and dilate again, you're not going to make any changes, which is not the same as saying if you had erode, 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 and dilate, 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 then that would be the same as erode and dilate. So you got that? So repeated openings, which are erode, dilate, that doesn't buy you anything more. But sometimes you want to erode either multiple times or with bigger shaped things and then and dilate again. So let me show you an example of using opening for like that cell colony thing we were talking about. It's a different picture, but it's the same idea. So here we have this Thomas Moslin, thank you very much, at in Aalborg. So here's an original image, okay, of some cells that are growing. Here is a binary image, okay? And this is the opening using a 11-pixel disk, all right? And you see that it pulls out, you know, these cells pretty well. And when you come over here, you say, okay, so it's got that one, 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 it's got that one. And, you know, clearly, maybe it misses this one. All right, maybe it misses this one. So this tends to be common in sort of these kinds of things. You can find some operation which tend to pull out what you want, but it's not going to be perfect. All right.